Hello and welcome back to another Carry On Crafting video. Today I will be showing you how to make the Crochet Captain America themed bauble. Let's get started. For this pattern you'll need a hook in the size 3.5mm, scissors and a yarn needle. You'll also need yarn in the colour white, navy blue and red. To start this pattern, we'll be doing a magic circle. We'll then be chaining 3 and doing 11 half double crochets into our magic circle. The chain 3 at the start of this round counts as our first half double crochet. So once you've done your 11 half double crochet, including your chain 3, you should have 12 stitches in total. Pull your magic circle end to close the loop. And slip stitch into the top of your chain 3. We're going to start our next ring with a chain 3 and doing 1 half double crochet into the same stitch as our chain. You're then going to do 2 half double crochets into every stitch around. So as we're coming to the end of our row of half double crochets, we're going to skip the last stitch for a second. And we're going to count that we have 22 2 stitches in total, including our chain 3 at the start. Once we have our 22 stitches into the last stitch in the round, we're going to do 3 half double crochets. So that in total for this round, we're going to have 25 stitches. Slip stitch into the top of our chain 3. Starting with round 3, this is where we're going to create our points for our start. So in the first stitch, we're going to do 1 slip stitch. Into our next stitch, we're going to do 1 half double crochet. And then 2 triple crochets into our next stitch. A half double crochet into our next stitch. And then a slip stitch into the next stitch. And that's how we create our points. Show you one more time. So slip stitch, half double crochet into the next stitch, two triple crochets into the next stitch, one half double crochet into the next stitch, and finish with a slip stitch. And repeat this around until you have your 5 points. Finishing off the last few stitches of ring 3. We're going to cut our yarn. Pull through to tie off, and we're going to move on to our second colour, which is the navy blue. So starting on any corner, doesn't matter which one, attach your navy yarn to the right triple crochet from the previous round. Slip stitch into the top of that triple crochet, and then slip stitch into the next triple crochet from the previous round. We're then going to do 1 half double crochet in the space of the half double crochet from the previous round, and then we're going to do 1 triple crochet in each of the 2 slip stitches that we did in the last round. So in this round, we're basically doing the opposite of what we did in the last one to create our circle. So half double crochet in the space of our half double crochet from the previous round. Slip stitching into the top of the triple crochet, and slip stitching into the next triple crochet from the previous round. continue this all the way around, and I'll meet you at the end. So finishing off our row, we're going to slip stitch into the first slip stitch that we did at the start of the round. So counting the amount of stitches that you have around, you should have 30 in total. We're going to tie off the end of our yarn, and we're going to go and switch to red now. So we're going to take our red yarn now, and we're going to slip stitch join onto our blue ring. We're going to chain three, and we're going to do a double crochet in the same stitch as our chain. We're then going to do one double crochet into the next stitch, and again until we get to our first corner. So we've got our stitch between our two triple crochets from the previous round. In this stitch, we're going to do two double crochets. And then we're going to go back to one double crochet in each stitch until our next corner. Here we are at our next corner, so we've got our two triple crochets and our stitch in between, and we're going to do another two double crochets. Doing this all the way around will allow us to add five extra stitches onto our stitch count. I'm going to continue until our last corner, and I'll meet you there. So we've got to our last corner, our last set of two triple crochet and the stitch, but because we added our extra double crochet at the start of the round, we're going to skip this corner and just do one double crochet. Do our last double crochet. And slip stitch into the top of our chain three from the start of the round. And that's our red row complete. So at the end of this row you'll have 35 stitches in total. We're going to tie off our red yarn and we're going to switch back to our loft. So we're going to attach our white yarn now. I'm just going to place it in the last stitch I did on the previous ring. I'm going to chain three. And do a double crochet into the same stitch as this chain. This counts as one of the five extra stitches that we need to do around this ring. So the other four will just be at equal points around the ring until you get to the end. So I'm going to keep doing one double crochet in each of my stitches. So I've done a few stitches, I'm not counting or anything, I'm just deciding that it's far enough away from the last one. You can count if you like, but that's completely up to you. So now we're adding a total of 5 extra stitches to our row. So the total stitches for the end of this row will be 40. I'm going to do our last double crochet. And then slip stitch into the top of our chain three at the start of the round. And this is your first half complete. You'll need to do this pattern one more time to get your two halves for the bauble. So come and join me when you're done. So here it is. I know I'm 4 years late, but go team cap. I've gone ahead and stuffed it as well as using the slip stitch method to join my two halves together, but you can use any method that works for you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please feel free to like and subscribe for more future content. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful Christmas.